Bruce, such an emotional night last night, such an atmosphere. Easy to have a letdown the night. Are you proud of your team that you're able to find a way?
Absolutely. I mean, it was a worry of mine all day. You know, I mean, an earlier game coming off that emotional game from last night, and a back-to-back to boot, and a team we haven't beaten. And so to have the third period, I thought that we needed to have. I mean, we hung on in the second, the first 10 minutes. I don't know if we touched the puck much, but the third period, we did a really good job.
The fourth line, you know, after the heavy workload that the top three lines got yesterday, how important was it for them to come through tonight the way they did?
And I was thinking about that, too, is they played great. I mean, I sometimes rely too much on the first two lines because there's penalty killers in that part and there's power play guys, but I thought Charlie at the end running right through him, I thought the Ek and Foligno getting on that goal, I mean, and Winnick, I mean, coming off a game where he sat out, I thought they did great.
How much brighter is the spotlight on the fourth line or the third defensive pair on the second back-to-backs when you know they may have to play a little more?
Well, the spotlight is on them, and especially when you're on the road. I mean, as you can't control a lot of times, especially if there's an icing, you know, on who's coming out against you. And, I mean, this team has been as hot as any team in the NHL except for maybe Nashville. So we knew they weren't going away.
Were you pretty dumbfounded by the second period and the decisions, especially after the effort last night, too?
The giveaways were not pretty. But, I mean, I think when your body or your mind gets tired, then your body goes, and or vice versa, one of the other things. And we got away with it, you know, because Dubnyk played so solid. I mean, in goal, you could his movements were so sort of non-existent, you know, like he wasn't all over the place, and he was in control of his game, which was great.
How much was starting Stalock yesterday a source of motivation from your end to Dubnyk?
Well, I mean, if Stalock was to play really well, I would think that Dubnyk would say, holy moly, you know, I mean, I gotta stay with the ship here and do the same thing. And he did, you know. So, I mean, it's great when you can get two goalies playing good. Usually you don't lose a lot of games.
How far back did you change your mind on splitting it from, you know, Dubnyk the first game and Stalock tonight? When did you make the switch?
No, I knew after the last game at home that Stalock was going to start. And I thought it was an emotional game for him because the thoughts were if he wins to keep playing. But I thought that would be pretty exhausting for a goalie. And Dubnyk came up and he did fabulous.
Fitting backdrop, too, for his 200th here, since this is kind of the jumping off point to what he's accomplished with you guys.
This is the team where he started to play good that was made other teams want to get him in a trade.
Winnick, was that just adding him to the rotation, or you hadn't been happy with him?
There was a couple things I wasn't really happy with, but he hadn't sat all year, and sometimes you need that little, you know, that whoa, you know.
Yeah.
You know, and I think that did it in the last half of the game today. I mean, he's played on some great teams recently, two President Trophy winners, and you know that he knows how to play when he's got his head on and he's thinking about the game.